here, although we calculated the circulation here, we needed 8 aircons. I think we can do without 4, so let's put some chairs up there. And on it goes. And that's the problem. The problem is a refusal to plan.
Yes.
And after having planned, a refusal to follow the plan. Now, there are very many reasons why this happens. And many of them have been touched upon by the various MPs. Zoning is all about money. You need to realize this. A single stroke of a colored pencil can change land value from 100 ringgit per square foot to 800 ringgit per square foot. You just have to color a square. The biggest land fraud color case was in Selangor, which I participated in blowing the whistle on, involved exactly that. We had a Padang PKNS, which was zoned as an open space, and along comes somebody who takes out a color pencil and colors a book. It was a forged book, by the way. And suddenly the land has gone up to 500 ringgit per square foot.
Whoa.
So the danger is in the colouring. And that's why I tell my children, learn to colour. I need to just get a few slides again. Okay. So I don't want to go through in detail the importance of planning control, why it's important. I'm just giving you some slides. I'm not going to sit here and bash DBKL or bash the minister. This problem has been around in the state of Selangor, Penang, everywhere else. As long as there's land, there's money, there's this kind of nonsense. But over the years, there's been an evolution. In Selangor, there's been a cleaning up. Even then, people are not happy, but there's been a cleaning up. And controls are being put in to give more say to the public in terms of the planning of their city, what they want, how they feel it should grow. Unfortunately, some have not refused to change. So this is an early one. I think you remember this one. This is the former Prime Minister who's actually going over an aeroplane looking at this K. Toyol's Bukit Cahaya, completely devastated. And he says he could not see it from his house there. It's like the whole thing's gone. So there's not a single day actually that passes where in some way planning and development control affects you all. You're feeling it today. Your playground, some of you gone. Your Bukit Damansara is, you know, now Bukit Gasing is no more Bukit Gasing. It's half a gasing already now, already cut off. You will see your community center gone. Everything is just ghost. The question is it illegal? Is it lawful? Is there elements of corruption involved? And what can you do about it? These are things which you're interested today. Now, I don't want to sit here and talk for 1 hour. I would rather answer every question you have. Okay? Whatever you have in your mind, I will be able to answer you to the best of my ability so that you get answers to your specific problems. Because just looking at the crowd here, I know all got specific problems today. Okay, now let's have a look. This was early in the days of Selangor, MPPJ, and the battle started there in 2000. This is all post-2008, okay? So the problem is it exists everywhere. It does not exist only in Kuala Lumpur, but there's been a lot of improvement under the new government in terms of public participation in the planning process. I was involved in all these cases, Kelana Jaya, where the land lakes were taken. In one case, somebody started pouring sand into the Kelana Jaya lake and issuing title and then saying that's my land. So every which way. As long as the honey is there, the bees will be there and they'll be working very, very hard over time. Okay? And these are some of the issues in Subang Jaya, and I won't go through all of them, I just want to just give you a flavor. Now I'm going to get down to the situation here. Okay, this was in Kota Damansara, there was a graveyard. In fact, in Kota Damansara, we had a forest reserve. And with one stroke of the pen, the Menteri Besar de-gazetted the whole forest and gave it to a few companies. One of them, Purple Star, with the Indonesian directors. We know all this. And then, of course, when the new government came over, they re-gazetted back the forest park of the Kota Damansara Forest Reserve. As far as Bukit Gasing is concerned, in Petaling Jaya, everything is protected. Triple protection. Gazette under Section 62 of the National Land Code, gazetted under the local plan RTPJ1, and also under our relevant bylaw. So we got triple level protection, and hopefully that will be able to hold it all, hold on to that very, very valuable piece of green. Now, this is a case where the cemetery was cleared. They took out the cemetery, they want to develop the cemetery, and many other cases. And these are from my archives, you know, 2007, 2008, a long time ago. Okay, so this was Bukit Damansara. This is 2008. This was again started back in Kuala Lumpur, and I remember I was involved in this. The Medan Damansara SDP, the landslides, you know, and then Mount Kiara started. Again, you can see this monster started in 2008, the attack on Mount Kiara. This, because people got a problem with green. They don't like to see green, and this is the difficulty. They see green, they don't see tree, they see money. And this training, unfortunately, badly trained when young, don't realize the importance.
When you ask any valuer, what is the value of a padang, and you'll be amazed at the rubbish that comes out. What is the development potential of the padang? What is the development potential of the forest? And you get some ridiculous valuations. The forest value is infinite. It cannot be replaced. So once you cut the tree, you cannot put those trees back. So the value should be infinite. It cannot be replaced. But that is not the valuation that is got obtained. That's why you go to cheap prices. You said in KL, suddenly land 50 ringgit, 100 ringgit a square foot. You try to buy land 50 ringgit, 100 ringgit, you can't get it. But certain privileged individuals can get at this kind of price. What do you value a children's playground? The value cannot value, because you cannot replace the child's playground anymore. Once gone, the green is gone, you built on it, it's the end of the story for that. So the values of these things, of what we call the green, should be higher than commercial, actually. The government valuation should say higher than commercial. Should be well, like, you know, 100,000 per square foot. That's what it should be. If you do that, end of this problem for all of you. No more problem. But that's not so.